Claudia,
we're gonna have
Claudia child because she don't have she don't have Fox Soul no more. She was around on her, she be on her IG now. It was her, Mimi, and some guy. And Mimi brought up how I had a different. Well, this is one part. I've already talking about Mimi losing the show because of Stevie J's connection to Puffy. Hold on.
Yes.
And I was up to host it. I was very disappointed in this. And it's not happening now.
Not happening. I was going to have a dating show with my daughter's father. And it was on BET Network. And they literally, we were going on probably 8-9 months of almost a year of planning and preparation and picking the cast and the whole nine.
Now, why the hell? Now, look, I watch BET and BET Plus. I have never known for them to need a year to plan a show, to pick cast people. Tyler Perry shoot TV shows in 2 days. Okay. And if y'all was taking a year to plan, first of all, Mimi child, a part of me feel like Mimi on some bullshit. Because why are they so loud, Mimi?
And allegedly, BET canceled the show because they didn't want the association with the situation with Puff and my daughter's father, who is really good friends with him. So this thing with him runs really deep. It runs deep to the point where it's messing up a lot of people's money.
Now, I want to say this, okay? Because a part of me feel, I just put it on mute, a part of me feel like, girl, Stevie J isn't connected enough currently to Puff to where that will stop a show for you. In my eyes, Stevie J's own actions, okay, Stevie J's own missteps could get a show canceled, okay? But I feel like trying to say, well, yeah, me and Steve, I had a dating show, Stevie was going to be on it as well, and because of we was working on it for a full year, okay? And for the full year, and all of a sudden, they canceled it because of Diddy. The whole reason he was on Love & Hip Hop was about his connection to Diddy and them from back in the day. He ain't worked with Diddy since the 90s. He ain't worked with Diddy since the 90s. So why would BET cancel the show about you and Stevie J? Unless they feel like Stevie J was also using the baby oil and people, okay? But I don't believe it. I don't at all. Now, Mimi also was talking about how she is good friends with Diddy's daughter, Chance's mama. Hold on.
You nervous to do this with today's news? A little bit.
I went and got the other part of the live. They was on live for like 2 hours. Okay? That was only one piece of Mimi saying that Stevie connecting to Diddy got my show canceled and blah, blah, blah. But before she, that was at the end of the thing. Okay? At the beginning of the live, she was saying this.
Yes. I was a little nervous. Let me get my disclaimer. Okay.
Again, this was from yesterday. So Claudia asked Mimi, because of what happened today, me and Diddy being arrested, you know, and your closeness to Diddy and Diddy people, you feel funny? You know, we have to discuss it. Okay.
Well, before you go, just so you know, the U.S. attorney said this is still an open investigation. Be careful.
That's why I want to get my disclaimer.
Okay. All right.
So, I don't know if you guys know, but one of my really, really good friends for 20-some-odd years is Diddy's baby mom that's still alive. And her daughter.
So, that's Chance's mama. So my thing is this, Mimi trying to say the show got canceled because of Stevie's connection to Diddy. But my thing is, currently you have a connection to Diddy because you close with his daughter's mama.
Daughter is like my niece. So with all of this going on, I'm out of respect for them. I'm going to, you know. So
So if Diddy's daughter is like your niece, you was best friends, best bone coons, best bosom buddies with Chance's mama. And don't forget y'all, Chance's mama also put her name on the line to help try and get Puff out of the jail currently. Okay?
You won't go in as deeply and as harshly as Talis and I. So in other words, you would need lube and Talis and I will go in with no lube.
If that's the analogy that we're going with, I would
that's
need
all I got.
Lube, I would need, yes.
And he just went right there, I guess. Well, yeah. Do we start with the...
Come on, yeah. If Diddy daughter is like your niece, okay, you have your own connection. So my thing was, you can't blame Stevie as the reason the show was canceled if you as well have a close connection to Diddy by way of his child's mama.
Baby oil, or do we just we put the baby oil on the shelf for the side?
Let's get right into it. Now, Diddy was arrested and taken into custody yesterday. Yeah. No bail was allowed, meaning he will remain in custody until the trial, which is almost...
I want y'all to watch this, just so that y'all can see Mimi still, in my opinion, slyly trying to defend Puff a little bit.
Unheard of. The lawyer tried to blame Cassie for that video that came out in the hotel. Remember the hotel where we all saw Cassie being dragged and kicked? The lawyer tried to say that a fight happened because he had gone through his phone and saw that he was cheating with someone else, and then she threw the phone at Diddy, and that's why he dragged her throughout the hotel lobby. I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Now, Aubrey O'Day has taken to social media to kind of post us, you know, say this is a win for women. Diddy, of course, will be trolling the fuck. 50 Cent will be trolling the fuck out of Diddy. The arrest was originally scheduled for today, but they said something happened prompting...
I don't know why that bad for this prop. I'm sorry, y'all.
...the arrest to happen a little bit earlier. They do say he is a flight risk, and that's why he is getting no bail. Now, the most, I don't know, interesting thing about this story, the things that they found, AR-15s, and a lot of baby oil. 1,000 bottles of baby oil and lube.
I'm sorry, I don't know. I'm going to have to see pictures and videos of that. That sounds absolutely ridiculous.
I'm sure you will.
Ridiculous.
We are definitely getting videos, Mimi. You're going to get your...
So even though Mimi said, I'm not going to say much because I know Chance, Mama, she my niece, I'm not going to say much. But you then say, that sounds ridiculous. If the police told you in the raid it was 1,000 bottles, that's what you're questioning, the lubrication?
Wish, I
want to see it because it just sounds so far out there. 1,000 bottles, not 918.
I want to see Homeland Security packing up the evidence van with all the bottles. You know, that, to me, that video, please, that would be one of the top videos of the month. I need to see that.
Jimmy, your perspective is you want to see the bottles of lube. Like, that's of all the evidence, that is the one
Well,
not the guns, the lube, the lubrication.
Check this out. They showed the guns, they showed the ammo, they showed all this other stuff. Why not show a picture of the 1,000 bottles? It just sounds ridiculous to me. I'm sorry.
I think it's an advertising thing. They don't want the, because you know, whoever it is, whatever brand it is, going viral tomorrow.
Also, this is the preliminary stuff of the thing. Once stuff is in court, that's when we will see more stuff. Now, I got some stuff here. I was going to watch this one second.
What other brands? How many brands are there of lube? There's not that many lubes, right?
There's a lot of lube brands out there.
Well, everybody ain't got that wet, Claudia. Okay? Everybody ain't got the wet.
I can't.
Those that know, Anyways, so maybe your issue is, of all the things, is you think that seems a little excessive. So does that make you, like, not believe some of the story? Like, does that make you think, like, they put in 10 on 20, or in this case, 1,000 on 100?
I believe that the media adds fuel to the fire. I honestly believe that. They will take a story and it'll be real, and they will just dump gasoline on that bitch to make it even more outrageous.
Oh, like when you told us that your bag was stolen and you and Nico ain't do no porn and somebody leaked it from, the lies you told Mimi, but you lied about the porn tape that y'all put together, Mimi. Yeah, so you be putting 20 on 10 too.
Okay. 1,000 bottles? Come on, man. That just
is baby oil flammable? Ridiculous. Is baby oil flammable? Real question. Real question. Anybody in the chat, let me know.
Oil, yes.
Okay, now, okay, of course, Mimi, because you are here, people are, of course, asking, what about Stevie? What about Stevie? Now, today, Stevie J, your baby daddy, he did post a video, took to social media, and posted a video of, like, just driving down the highway, smooth sailing, plane shot eight, kind of giving a vibe of not a care in the world. What say you?
Baby oil music.
The way my algorithm is set up, I don't see anything that Stevie J does. So I don't know what he did today. This is the first time I'm hearing about him driving down the highway playing shot. I don't know what that man does.
So you don't know what that man do, but y'all gonna have a TV show together. You don't know what he do, but you was gonna have a show with him. Okay.
Hey, Sade is baby oil music. Let me tell you.
It is baby oil.
Oh, it is.
He was driving down what coast? What was it? Was it like beach on the side? Like what?
It wasn't. Yeah, what was that? It looked like middle America. I will say this, the shocking thing to me, Mimi, because I know you and him for a very long time, I was shocked that he had a car.
Claudia messy. Claudia's messy.
Mimi, you ain't about to eat every time you don't want to answer something or a comment. Did he take your car, Mimi?
My car in the garage, babe. My car's in the garage.
Faith Evans, people, is there a car missing from your garage or your driveway? Is one of the fleet?
Claudia really trying to have Foxhole TGIF on her IG. She is.
Are you one shy in your fleet, Faith Evans? Because someone's car had to be used, right?
You ain't right.
Maybe it was a rental, or maybe it's the chick he with now. Who knows whose car it is?
Come on.
How many bottles of KY and Baby L do you think that he had in his trunk as he got away?
Got away?
Messy.
What?
That nigga made off with the baby oil in the car. Oh my god!
But she feel like Diddy was the one connected to Stevie J, and that's why our show got canceled. It may have been you.
Somebody gotta do a cartoon of this shit for real.
So he called Kalina. Apparently, Diddy called Kalina 54 times in the Southern District of New York. Has those taped calls? Mimi, you know that I have a Diddy story from back in the day when he was like blowing me up about a picture that was posted to social media, to a blog, and he was mad at me. It's my only time talking to him on the phone. He blew me up like 57 times in one day, and it was like, it went from highs to lows. It's the only time I ever talked to him on the phone. He was cussing me out because a picture we took at the BET Awards ended up on a blog that someone took up on my MySpace page. So I know he does get like manic like that, where he just goes.
So Claudia's saying, yeah, Diddy get manic. Yeah, he went manic on me, called me 57 times. So again, people knew of Diddy's behavior.
What can you say? I know you've been around him. I might ask you to, you know, trash him. But what can you say about his personality, about, you know, how he's going to be on it? Like, he ain't
So even though Mimi said, I'm not going to speak much because I'm close with the man's daughter and the daughter mama, but Claudia still asked her, what do you think about Diddy? You can't pay me to discuss my niece's father who's already in jail for a whole bunch of shit. I would say next question.
When it comes to something that he wants to get across, he won't stop. And I think that's where Can't Stop, Won't Stop came from. He will not stop. He will, if he's trying to get in touch with you, he will.
So is this good for the prosecution? Because if people who know him, and it's close to the daughter's mama, and the daughter's my niece, Diddy daughter, my niece, and she's saying, if he wants to get at you, he gonna get at you. Mimi, you gonna be called as a witness, okay? They are gonna subpoena you tonight.
He will do that. He's going to get in fucking touch with you. So he's a relentless human being, I will say that.
He's a relentless human being. People is on social media saying, while you on trial for beating and kidnapping and all these things, your daughter's auntie, your baby mama good friend, your baby mama good friend is on the social media telling the people you are a relentless human being. And you want it, you're going to get it.
So, yes, the multiple calls, I understand.
Do you feel bad for Diddy, Mimi? Mimi, do you feel bad for Diddy?
Now, she asked Mimi directly, do you feel bad for Diddy? Mimi did not answer the question at all. She kept sitting there eating her food. The dude then changed the subject, but I didn't care, kind of put it apart. But Mimi did not answer the question.
I love the silence. I love it. Keep eating, Mimi. Keep eating.
Bad?
Again, Mimi did not answer the question. She did not say yes or no.
Jerome Trammell, who was a producer on Fox, so I'm going to read it. He said, blowing up Kid Cudi's car for talking to Cassie. No wonder why so many people have kept silent.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
What are y'all thoughts of? Do you think a lot of people were just so scared all these years and that's why no one said anything? And then once Cassie kicked that door open, it kind of gave
that open confidence. Floodgates.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I used to hear stories, at least on my end, and like on the radio.
Now, I don't know who that man is, but I think that man is somebody. I just don't know who.
I would just hear, you know, artists come up, they just kind of talking. And there was definitely a disconnect between people, how they view Diddy, especially at his height, you know, and then people that actually knew Diddy as far as like, you know, look, it's well documented. Dude has anger issues, you know, he's prone. He's been, you know, look, I ain't snitching. Hey, prone to violence. Look at Steve Stout, you know.
Because y'all know he allegedly hit Steve Stout in the head with a bottle. Or was it a bottle or a phone? He hit him with something. Got in trouble. Steve Stout got paid.
Man got a lot of money out of Diddy because of that, you know.
Wait,
that
the Steve Stout thing allegedly was Diddy allegedly holding him by his feet on the side of a building, right? Isn't that true?
No, it was a bottle involved. Well, the word was he beat him, went into the offices and beat him with a bottle.
Got it.
Allegedly.
These fools is on IG Live giving the prosecution ammunition. Okay. And this man, y'all not helping nothing.
Oh, this is all alleged. Allegedly. Wasn't this story we heard about him doing that with a woman?
Oh, wait. No, I ain't heard that one. No, that's new. Allegedly. So, yeah, we might have to throw that on there.
We have to say
Tasha.
Okay.
The baby got it, too. Look at that baby.
This is very unfortunate.
So, y'all listen to Mimi right now. Listen to Mimi.
I'm for his kids.
Oh, yeah.
This is very unfortunate because this... Puff was like black excellence, and for it to turn out the way it did, for his life to have gone from where it was to now, is insane.
He had such a great life. He was an icon, and don't look at him now. He's in jail because of what he did. Like, I feel like it's his fault.
However, let me say this. The way America prosecutes black men versus non-black men is incredible to me.
Every time a black man does something, I hate how people then say, oh, I know he beat somebody savagely on camera. Oh, I know that's horrible. But the way they want to prosecute him and not the white, I'm like, everybody should be prosecuted. Period. We can't say, well, they didn't do the white man. Well, so what? We know that. We are aware of that. But nobody should get away with it. Do we want more people of other races to also get in trouble? Yes, we absolutely do. But that does not mean we want black men to get off for doing it. We want everyone to be on the hook for it.
Because you could have a non-black man do the same thing and worse. And they're walking around scot fucking free. Make it make sense.
Well, usually, it was caught on tape. Stuff happens, usually. However, I still don't think that has anything, like, that'll have nothing to do with what Diddy did. What the white man did to his girlfriend, that does not mean that Diddy should be able to do it too. Because if the white man got away with it, then the black man should get away with it. I was like, now what? What?
Make it make sense.
True. But that still don't make me want him to be off because his victims are all black people.
Well, I think they locked up Jeffrey Epstein. I think. I gotta go look that up. Somebody brought that up.
Yeah.
I don't think that during the trial, I think they kept him in jail as well. You know what I'm saying?
That's one out of how many? One out of how many?
Yeah. Had a lot of.
The point should never turn into let's discuss how many white men did it. To me, that is in a way defending Diddy by saying it's horrible how they are treating the black man that beat up the black people. Because if he was white, they wouldn't do nothing. If he was white, he would still need to be. When we see Caucasian crimes, we complain too. We don't say, oh, we don't care. We complain too. I'm like, Mimi, girl, what? And again, the blogs didn't show y'all none of this, right? Because you wonder why the blog people don't like doing they due diligence like I do. I told y'all, look, bitch, look. You know what I'm saying? I'm a clip this and make it a shorter video for tomorrow because I'm like, I know folks don't know. But I mean, like, you can't. Mimi wanted, but they want to post. What the blog folk want to post, though, Mimi talking about, oh, because of Diddy, I lost my dating show. They didn't want to show her saying, oh, but Diddy should be getting off because he's a black man. And when the white people do it, they...
True. But that still don't make me want him to be off because his victims are all black people.
Well, I think they locked up Jeffrey Epstein. I think. I gotta go look that up. Somebody brought that up.
I
don't think that during the trial, I think they kept him in jail as well. You know what I'm saying?
That's one out of how many? One out of how many?
Yeah. Had a lot of baby oil situations, too. I'm just comparing the two baby oil, you know, it's like a baby oil.
He had a lot of babies. Listen, you have, of course, you have an argument in that. And you're right. It's true. Yeah. They definitely go after. They're definitely more corrupt and difficult and on point on black men, you know, when they commit a crime. And
that's true.
Black 1,000%. When white men rape with evidence, it's like slap on the hand, a few months probation, even sometimes. We don't want to ruin their life. And with a black man, a lot of times just a mere story, an allegation on you will ruin your life. That is true. But with this case, with cases that there's extreme history of decades and decades and decades and decades of stories, allegations, evidence, I don't feel bad for black men that commit crimes against black people. I do not. Black women, especially, the most disrespected person in the universe. You know what I mean? Like, and when it comes to that, I'm like, nope, sorry, don't care.
Because we all know that any man that commits a crime against anybody, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, it doesn't matter. If you committed a crime, then you should, justice should be done, period. That's just the bottom line.
You were going to have a dating show.
Yeah.
And I was up to host it. I was very disappointed in this. And it's not happening now,
it's
right?
not happening. I was going to have a dating show with my daughter's father. And it was on BET Network. And they, literally, we were going on probably 8-9 months of almost a year of planning and preparation and picking the cast and the whole nine. And allegedly, BET canceled the show because they didn't want the association with the situation with Puff and my daughter's father, who is really good friends with him. So this thing with him runs really deep. It runs deep to the point where it's messing up a lot of people's money.
I'm really sorry to hear that because that would have been a great check for both of you.
Man, it was going to be an amazing check. However, you know, the network had their reasons why. And
I totally understand.
Again, I'm sorry. And allegedly.
Allegedly.
That is why. But here we are. So your association with things, don't like, you just can't take that lightly. If someone says, listen, you need to disassociate, do it.
Yeah.
I really hate that for you, man, for both of you. I know you both. It would have been great. I think, you know, I've known you for many, many years. Mimi and I go back to, I think, 97, 98.
Yes.
And she's a great spirit, great personality. I love her. That's my dog. Like, we're lifelong friends. Like, ain't nobody going nowhere. Like, we're locked in. And I just think you're fun, like, you're hilarious. And, you know, I love hip hop. People saw you always mad with a vein in your head. But I'm like, you're so much more than that.
I had a reason to be mad, though.
I think so.
I had a whole reason to be mad. I wasn't just mad for no reason.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
Mimi, we understood, though. We trust me. I think the normal person watched it. We got it.
The normal people did, but the not normal people, like, why the fuck she always yelling? Why she always cursing? I'm like, are you kidding me?
I mean,
are you fucking kidding me? Like, this was another thing. They were like, you knew what you were getting yourself into. Absolutely not. I absolutely did not know. I didn't fucking know.
Yeah.
You didn't, because I remember when you guys really got, like, when you first got with them, he was very successful, had all the, like, he was popping. Yep. And then he fell on hard times. There was some time, you know, he wasn't getting his money, and Diddy was withholding, I believe. I'm going to say that. You're not saying this, my opinion. And I remember you holding him down. I remember you didn't have a, don't call me right now, please.
Proposals.
So I remember, Mimi had a successful company. She had a cleaning business. It had corporate clients, celebrity clients, which we won't even get into that.
I can't wait. Yo, we got to do this again.
Listen, the crazy part is when I started the show and she kept calling me a maid, I'm like, I have my own business. A maid? And that was the whole thing. And still to this day, people will say, hey, maid to me because of her, which is so, I'm like.
Not only did you own the business. Stevie didn't have a car, and he was driving your car. She was getting much less than you were getting on Love & Hip Hop per episode. I'm gonna go ahead and say it so you don't have to say it. And I just thought, like, well, this maid is doing better than both of y'all, because you need her car to get the set.
The shit goes viral every year. Like, every year, that scene goes viral.
And so, Mimi was living in a mansion with a friend of hers and had the whole bottom floor. Okay? Mm-hmm. We'll just say that. A female friend of hers and a married couple that they were good friends with, and then they were, Mimi, like, helped this lady a lot.
Yeah.
And he was using her car, and I remember going over there because she did not have a baby shower, and me and Alta, the girl that introduced me to Mimi,
yeah,
we went and brought a baby shower to her. We brought her a bunch of stuff for Eva when she was still in. Did you have a baby at the time?
Mm-hmm.
Was she born yet?
No.
When were you pregnant? I can't remember.
No, and when you guys brought this stuff, yeah, she was
fresh
little. Fresh.
And I remember Stevie was so humble and being so catering to you. Like, I remember he was cooking you steak and bringing, like, I understand why you were, like, you loved him. You know, people see the end result, the Love & Hip Hop version, but I remember the struggle version. I remember you holding him down, and he was grateful at the time for you looking out. And then the show came about, and it kind of, you know what I'm saying, people go back to the game, the ego thing happens, but, you know, you are a good woman to him. And you were not mad for no reason. How you were played with on that show was fucked up, and I'll never forget when you was like, when you finally got your get back and you was like, that's the Stevie I know. When he did that bullshit
With the rings. Yeah, that's typical Stevie J shit. Yeah.
I also remember when we went to Eric B's house for a rooftop party. And I flew in. And Mimi said, I said, where do I put my luggage? I went right from the airport to the party. And I said, where do I put my luggage? And she said, go in the back room. And I went in the back room. And I walked in on something.
Any other topics we can discuss now?
This is what you told me the other. This is the same.
Somebody about to get. Well, I'm not gonna say because people, you know, someone's about to get topped off. I'm like, you got her in one room. That's when he's out of get area. But you know what? He's charismatic. He's funny, and we squashed our little thing. We cool now because on my birthday, you called in when we were in Aruba.
Yes,
and we squashed our little shit. We good now. Thank you.
We'll be right back.